Hello everyone, welcome back to your English language class. I hope the topics which we have discussed earlier are all clear to you, and if any kind of doubt is there, please ask those in the comment section below. And please make sure that while practicing English language over there, you have to practice the works every single day. Don't skip it, otherwise you will not be in the sync. Okay, so today we are going to learn about our next topics, which is about adverbs over there. In this very video, we are going to learn about different kinds of adverbs as well as their usages, and along with that we are going to study about the position, how we are going to arrange adverbs over there in a sentence, and also if any case in a sentence more than one adverb is there, which pattern they are going to be follow over there, how we are going to arrange it. So let's start it. First of all, what are adverbs? Please tell me, what is an adverb? Adverb, from the name itself, it's very much clear that it's a word which is adding something to the meaning of the verb itself. Add verb, add something to the verb itself, that is your adverb over there, right? How many kinds of adverbs are there? There are different kinds of adverbs, like adverb of manner, adverb of time, adverb of place. Also we can say that different adverbs over there. See first of all the example of an adverb, how it modifies a verb. See the example, she sang beautifully. In this very sentence, which is your verb? It is sang. But the way, the how she sang over there, she sang beautifully, that beautifully is your adverb. And which is the verb it is modifying? It is modifying the very verb sang, right? See the another example, she is a very good singer. In this very sentence, she is modifying which very word over there? Singer over there, they are talking about singing, right? And how she is singing? Good over there, that good is your adverb. It will modify the adjective good over there. Then she will arrive soon. Like that, a very particular verb which will modify the verb over there, that will be your adverb in the sentence. Now let's study different kinds of adverbs over there. First of all, the first kind is adverb of manner. Adverb of manner tells us how that particular action has been performed. The very word how, it will tell you adverb of manner itself. See the example, he works hard. The way that particular person is working, that will be your adverb of manner. How he has worked? He has worked hard over there. That hard will be your adverb of manner. Next comes adverb of place. From place itself, it is very much clear that it will tell us the place of that very action, where that action has been performed over there. So where will tell you adverb of place. For example, my friends are playing in the ground, right? So that ground will be your adverb over there. Outside, inside, anything that will tell you or indicate the place of the action, that will be your adverb of place itself. Then next comes adverb of time. It will tell you at which time, when that action has been performed, right? In morning, in the evening, early, later, all those things, the time of that very action. Next is adverb of frequency. Adverb of frequency will tell you how often that action has been performed, whether it is being done in the regular basis or seldomly, how often that action take place over there. See the example, she seldom comes here, or he often makes mistakes. Next comes adverb of degree. It will show you how much of that action has been done or is left over there, or to which very particular extent that action has been performed. For example, are they fully ready, right? Next comes adverb of affirmation and negation. Affirmation means a positive, when we agree with that very statement itself, and on the other hand, negation means when we disapprove of that very thing, not over there, right? So those will be your affirmation and negation. He will certainly come, for example. There certainly is your adverb of affirmation, right? Adverb of affirmation. And the last one is adverb of reason. The very point, or we can say the reason behind that cause why we have performed that very action over there, that will be your adverb of reason itself. For example, he therefore left the country. There might be a situation, there might be a reason over there that why he has taken that very step. That reason will be your adverb of reason. Next comes positions of adverb, the most important part of this very section, that how we are going to arrange adverbs in a sentence over there, right? Now it will be a simple thing. First of all, in the sentence we have to find adverbs over there. After finding that, we have to find that to which very particular category that adverb is belonging over there. After that, we can apply the proper rules and regulations to situate them in that very sentence itself, in which very sequence they have to be arranged. See, the first of all, when it will be an adverb of manner, then that adverb of manners are generally placed after the verbs or after the object in the sentence itself. When the verb will be there, your adverb of manner will be after that very verb itself. Next comes the adverb of place and also time. Adverb of place are placed after the verb or after the object itself. For example, they arrived late. Arrived is your verb over there, and at which very time they have arrived, that will be after that very verb itself. Next comes adverb of frequency. Frequency, we have already studied that how often, right? How often that action has been performed. In case of adverb of frequency, what we are going to do? We are going to apply those adverbs of frequency between the subject and the verb. It will be in between both the things, subject and the verb as well. And if the verb consists of more than one verbs over there, then it will be after the very first verb. In this very rule, we are going to study two different things. That if our verb is of only one word, then our frequency's adverb will be in between the subject as well as the verb, right? But if in case the verb is more than one over there, then our adverb of frequency will be after the very first word itself. Keep it in your mind. Next comes if any helping verbs are there. For example, is, am, are, was, were, all the helping verbs over there. Then our adverb will be after those helping verbs itself. There are some exceptions to these cases also. For example, the helping verbs over there have to and used for. These adverbs will be normally placed before these very helping verbs over there. In these cases, helping verb will be before that. Next comes often. Often also, and the very word enough also. It will be placed after the adjective which it modifies. Now, if a situation arises that there are more than one adverb in the same sentence, how we are going to arrange them? Let's take the example, if we are going to arrange adverb of place and an adverb of time in the same sentence, how we are going to that, which pattern we will follow? It will be like that, adverb of place will be at the first place and the adverb of time will be after that. Then if we wish to emphasize the adverb of time, we may place it before the adverb of place. Only an exceptional case, if we need to put stress on the time of that very action, then only we can place it at the beginning. Next comes, if an adverb is giving the number of time an event occurs, normally it will come before the adverb of time itself. Also, this very same rule will apply when often is used. Often is sometimes used at the end of the sentence. For example, he used to come here often last year. Last year is also the time, but we have often is used over there, so it will be before that. So these are the rules and regulations about different kinds of adverbs and the sequence in which we are going to arrange it in our sentence over there. Go through these rules and regulations, solve your practice papers as well as with the assignments of this very chapter, and revise the rules. Thank you.